As reported by the Belfast Telegraph, scientists reverse aging process. A way to reverse aging has been discovered, which allows withered muscle to rebuild itself by turning back a biological clock. The effect has already been demonstrated on human muscle tissue in the laboratory. Scientists in the US believe the breakthrough could lead to new treatments that rejuvenate and strengthen aging bodies or combat degenerative diseases. Their findings also underline the importance of staying active for older people, since this reduced age-related muscle loss. What practical value does money and time spent on ways to reverse the aging process have, when at this very moment, millions of people exist in poverty and without food to nourish themselves? What practical value does money and time spent on prolonging the lives of the elderly of the world have, when at this very moment, children are sick and dying of malnutrition and famine? Why is it that poverty, starvation, circumstances of desperation and misery experienced by human beings is accepted and not given priority attention? Why has a solution not been found to the suffering and death of millions of human beings that occurs at this very moment? Why is combating the aging process and retaining a youthful body and appearance given funding and attention as a priority area of scientific research and development? Who is reviewing such research? Who is providing the funds? No doubt, those who would want to prolong their own life. Does not the acceptance of such areas of research and development as having priority over the end of starvation and death of millions of children reveal that the majority of the scientific community is not considering the betterment and well-being of humanity, despite its claims to be doing so? Does this not reveal that the majority of the scientific community is programmed not to see common sense and consider what actually requires our attention in this reality, what actually requires a solution above all else? Does this not also reveal that the majority of human beings are programmed not to see common sense and do not regard the major problems of humanity as priority concerns? Peer review is part of the problem. It is common sense that funding and support should be given to those areas of research and development which exist within the starting point of establishing and implementing solutions for the betterment of life for all human beings equally. In this, the primary problems of starvation, lack, non-access to electricity, healthcare, and education should be given absolute priority within the considerations of those who are reviewing and deciding the value and attention given to proposed scientific research and development. Because it is common sense that until humanity as a whole sorts out its equilibrium and corrects the current design of the world system, which is inequality, self-interest, and disregard for the suffering of the many in favor of giving attention to the wants and desires of the few with money, that any claim by science to exist for the betterment and well-being of humanity is a dishonest and delusional statement. However, it is seen that peer review, which should be undertaken by a community of human beings as peers, equal in the consideration of what best supports humanity as a whole in common sense, not influenced or limited by personal motives, self-definitions, a predefined knowledge base, desires, beliefs, or opinions, is rather undertaken by a group of people existing within the same or similar knowledge base and ideology as those submitting their ideas and research for review. Yet within the definition of peer review, it is stated that a community of experts in a given field is required who are qualified to perform an impartial review. The only impartiality evident is the impartiality towards what in common sense should be considered within a review of any proposed area of scientific research, funding, and development. which is what actually is considering a solution to the priority problems of humanity at this moment. It is evident that human beings are programmed to accept science and scientists to exist apart from the rest, within their own bubble of superiority as knowledge, and that the majority of human beings do not take it upon themselves to evaluate the starting point of science, within seeing what actually considers the betterment of the lives of all humanity as a whole, as equals. This reveals that human beings do not take it upon themselves to evaluate their own starting point, and that all exist within the consideration of only their own personal interests. And it is also evident in the nature of the majority of scientific research that within the scientific community, the common sense evaluation of one's starting point within considering if the research being participated in actually is relevant to the points in this world that require attention is neglected. What is needed is a community, a group of people that take it upon themselves to evaluate and purify their own starting point through self-honesty and common sense, and to evaluate the starting point of actions taken by all the major institutions of this world, within the consideration of what actually supports the well-being of all humanity. What is needed is a group of people willing to develop common sense in all ways, and to take the action required to spread awareness that there exists a monstrous waste of resources and money within the pursuit of research and development in areas of science and other institutions. Resources and money that could be used to achieve an equal quality and standard of life for all humanity. It's time to wake up from the delusional belief that science is here for the benefit of humanity. It's time to ask the question, where is the voice of the people? And isn't it the people's duty, isn't it our duty, to be the voice of those in this world who are not able to have a voice?